Welcome aboard. It's Captain G with January 2027 Western Alliance turn. The Allies had quite a turn, and as we mentioned, the tides had turned last time. And if we take a look at the victory point tracker, we see that this is how it looked a few turns ago, but the opposite ends for each side. The final neutrals, as we expected, went with the Western Allies, Mexico and Cuba. Cuba was just waiting to be invited to join NATO, and Mexico wanting to be a part of the US. The Russians were nuked, more to lock them down and prevent any kind of counterstrike, while NATO and their allies, the US and Pacific Caliphate, struck into the Caliphate homeland, capturing both Iran, Pakistan, and Central Caliphate, leaving Turkey as the last holdout for the Caliphate. And China, the South China Industrial Zone, has been completely captured by the US. Since their forces have been nuked in Southeast Asia and Guam, the MAGTAF pivoted, picked up infantry from Indonesia, and used them for the invasion, supported by a ton of air and cruise missile strikes, which took out some of the defending Chinese infantry and then secured China. And then, as is becoming a tradition, North Korea was nuked by South Korea. This longbow strike deep into the heart of Russia was unexpected, capturing the third victory city this turn, as well as capturing South Ukasia, which was only valuable because of the ICBMs that were here. So that destroyed much of the remaining Russian ICBMs. So got to develop an Eastern Pack strategy. I think that strategy will include at least 5 nukes, but beyond that, I don't know what we can do against the juggernaut, but Kim Jong-un will want to strike against South Korea regardless, so that's where one of the nukes will go. We'll keep you posted as we quickly approach what I suspect will be the end of the game. Captain G, out for now.